For this question, you're asked to modify the compute ranks code in order to take into consideration whether links are reciprocal or not. So what we want to know is AC a reciprocal link? It's a reciprocal link if there is a path from C back to A of at most length K, where K is a number that's given to us. If there is a path back, then we won't include A in the calculation for C's rank. So I'm going to look at the values of K. K equals 0. I'm going to ask, is AC reciprocal? And then from that, I'll be able to tell whether to include A or not in the calculation of C's rank. So if K equals 0, this is the link we're looking at. If K equals 0, the only links that are excluded are the self links, links to the page itself. So AC is not reciprocal in this case, and we should include A in C's calculation. If K equals 1, we're looking to see if there's a direct link back from C to A, and there isn't. So AC is not reciprocal, and we should include A. If K equals 2, we need to see if there's a path of length 2 from C to A. So if we start at C, then we can only get to D. That's used at one of the two links we're allowed to click on to get back to A. So what we want to know now is, can we click on one link from D to get back to A? And the answer is no, we can't, which means that AC is not reciprocal. We should include A. If K equals 3, we're going to do the same again. We start at C, we go to D using at one link, then we want to know if by using two clicks we can get back from D to A. Let's have a look at that. From D, we can get to B, and then that uses up one link. And then can we get to A with one more link? Yes, we can, because there's a direct link from B to A, which means that AC is reciprocal and we should not include A. If K is greater or equal to 3, then there's definitely a path of length at least 3 in there, which means we should not include A for any values of k greater than or equal to 3. And so now we're going to code that. We're going to code a procedure to check whether AC is reciprocal, and then we're going to edit the code in compute ranks to take that into consideration. So this is the supplied code, and I'm going to change it to include a second input k. And then we want to know whether we have that reciprocal link or not. So we include the page. If we don't have a reciprocal link in the graph, we're going to include node in the calculation if the link node to page is not reciprocal. So I just need to adjust the spacing here, and that's all the change that we need to do to compute ranks. To code is reciprocal link, I'm going to use recursion. So if k is 0, that was the first case we looked at in the example, then we have a reciprocal link whenever the destination and the source are the same. So in that case, I'll return true, and otherwise, we return false. If k is not equal to 0, then it's at least 1, which means if there's a direct link from the destination to the source, then there's most definitely a reciprocal link. And if that's not the case, we're going to look at every node that is linked to from destination, and we're going to check if there's a path of links from that node to the source of length k minus 1. We've already used one step going from destination to node. That leaves us with k minus 1 steps left. So if there is a path, in other words, if reciprocal link graphs, we're in the same graph, we've got the same source, we've got our new node, which is hopefully one step closer to the destination. If that's true, then we're going to return true. And if there is no node for which that's true, we're going to return false. And that completes the procedure.